Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of NetBeans IDE on a Windows 10 operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how to run a simple Hello World Java program within our NetBeans IDE. So this video is going to be a bit informative, so it will be long, but I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you will be learning a lot of new things. And if you are new to this channel, then please do subscribe our channel, that will really motivate me to make more such videos. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now before installing NetBeans IDE, it is very important to install Java first. So in my previous videos, I have already showed you how to install Java, so it is just simply type on your browser JDK download, and you need to click on this Java downloads, and you need to download the latest version of Java, which is Java 21 at the time of making of this video. You can also download Java 17, it totally depends upon you which version you want to code, and you need to switch to your operating system and you need to download the MSI version. Alright, so on my previous videos, I have already showed you in detail how to install Java, so please follow that video. I'll be providing that link in the description. So once you have Java installed, it's time to install our NetBeans. So for that, you need to again, you know, go to your favorite browser, open a new tab, and just simply type NetBeans download and hit enter, and immediately you'll be seeing this NetBeans. So netbeans.apache.org, so just, you know, simply click on that link and you'll be landed over to the official site of Apache NetBeans. So this link I'm going to put right in your description. So once you are here, you'll be able to see Apache NetBeans version 21 is available to download. So at the time of making of this video, that is on February 20th, the latest version is NetBeans 21. So if you're watching this video much later, you might be seeing NetBeans version 22 or 23. So whatever version it shows, the steps that I'm going to show you on this video will be pretty much same. Alright, so you don't need to worry. So all you need to do is, you need to click on this download button, and it's going to redirect to this downloading Apache NetBeans. So here you can see we have, under installer and packages, we have all these links. So for Windows, I'm going to proceed with this one. If you are using Linux, then you need to, you know, proceed with all those links below. So for Windows, you need to click on this link and it's going to redirect to the official site of Apache Software Foundation page, and here you can see this link. So to click on this link, and immediately it's going to start downloading our Apache NetBeans, right? So I'm going to cancel this as I have already downloaded it. So I'm going to provide this Apache NetBeans download link on my description, so you can use that link also to land over here. Right, so if I go to my download directory, you can see Apache NetBeans is already been downloaded over here. So I'll just simply double click on the installer, and it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. So it is rightly started configuring the installer. And there you go. So welcome to Apache NetBeans IDE 21 installer. Right, so everything is properly set. So it's going to come up with base ID, then Java EC, Java EE, then HTML5, JavaScript, PHP. So for all these different languages, you can use your NetBeans IDE. And you can see that total installation size is 944 MB. So on your C drive, so you need to have this much amount of free space. All right, so that's just a point you need to remember. All right, so everything is properly set. Just simply click on next. So this is our license agreement. You can always read this. You can always accept the license agreement. Click on next. So as we were talking about at the beginning of the video, that it is very important to install Java. So you can see that JDK path, that is on program files, Java, JDK 21, they have properly recognized. All right. So if you're using JDK 17, so in that case, it should show JDK 17. So that's why I have told at the beginning of the video that it is very important to install your Java, right? Since I have already Java installed, I have also set Java home on my environment variable. So everything is properly set. So we are good to go to install our NetBeans. All right. So you can see that on our program files, it's going to create a NetBeans 21 folder, and then it's going to install all the files right at this directory. All right. So everything is set. So you can just simply click on next. So you can see now under summary, it has also checked this check for updates, which is totally fine. And you need to have 944 MB. All right. So everything is, you know, you need to keep default and click on next. and you can see our installation is readily begun. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. So we'll come back and you can see that our Apache NetBeans IDE is successfully installed. So you can just simply click on finish. So you can minimize your download directory as well, and here you can see that our Apache NetBeans IDE 21 desktop shortcut is also created over here. So you need to just simply double click on the software to launch our Apache NetBeans. And you can see that our Apache NetBeans IDE is rightly started launching. And you can see that it is rightly launched. So let's first maximize this. And here I'm going to create a new Java project. So I'll go to file and click on new project. So that will open this new project window. So here I'm going to select Java with and. So I'm going to create a hello world simple Java application. So I'm going to select Java with and then I'm going to click on next. So immediately it will start configuring our Java cluster. And you can see that our Java is rightly activated. So now it's time to give our project name. So let's give the project name as Hello World. Right. So you can see our project name is now Hello World. Our project location is rightly set along with our project folder. So everything is properly set. We have also checked this create main clause. So it's going to first create a Hello World package. And after that, it's going to create our Hello World class. All right, so for class, always remember that our first word of the class name is always in block letter. All right, so yeah, that's why it is in capital letter. So everything is properly fine. Just simply click on finish, and immediately you can see it is rightly started creating our projects. So let's wait for a minute. And you can see that our project is rightly created. So hello world.java file is also rightly opened over here. So here, if you just simply hit enter, and if you type something like system.out.println, then hello world. So after that, you can, if you just simply click on this run button, immediately you can see that our project is rightly started building. And after successfully built, when our build gets successful, you can see the output hello world is rightly shown on our console. Alright, so in this way you can easily create a simple Hello World project within our NetBeans IDE, and you can start your programming journey. Alright, so that's basically all about this video. Please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I'm posting coding related videos. So please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with our Geeky Script vlogging channel as well. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.